first date and last date, return the first and the last date in the current selection packed inside a table. And they are useful as a time intelligence function because their result can be used as a filter argument of calculate. Let's see their behavior. We define a selection that starts from the 15th of August 2008 up to the 31st of August 2008, which is then used to apply a filter to the filter context. If you use calculate table last date returns a table that contains the last date, the last day in the current selection, that is the 31st of August. If instead of using last date, we use first date, then the result will be the 15th of August. We run the query and you see that now the result is the 15th of August. The result of these functions is a table. Like any other time intelligence function, they return tables. And the reason is you will probably use these functions as filter arguments in calculate. You see in this example, the inner function does calculate sales amount, last date, date, date. Last date returns a table containing the last date visible in the current filter context. And the filter context is set by the outer calculate that uses a range of dates. The outer calculate is typically not present in your code. It is set by the Power BI report or by the client tool that executes your measure. You write the code inside that computes the value for only one day. So this value, 386.51, is the amount of sales in the last day in the selection, that is on the 31st of January 2008. As with any other time intelligence calculation, you need to pay attention to the arguments that you pass. Because even though you write last date, 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 the engine actually rewrites your code because last date does not accept a date reference as an argument, it requires a table. If you only use a data argument like in this case, the engine rewrites it as calculate table distinct date date. The presence of calculate table is important because context transition might happen because of calculate table. So if you execute this code in a row context, you need to pay attention to the fact that context transition might happen and you might obtain a result which is kind of unexpected. Let's now look at an example of using first date and last date. In this query, we iterate over the years and month, and we compute the sales in the first date and the sales in the last date of the current selection. The result of the query contains the sales amount, the sales in the first day of the selection, and the sales in the last day. Because we didn't sell anything on the 1st of January, you see that sales in first day returns a blank, and sales in last day are the sales on the 31st of January 2007.